Hey everybody, I just wanted to record a quick video to help you get started on the Pascal's Law Lab. We've talked about Pascal's Law recently. It has to do with pressure and how pressure is exerted equally in all directions. So you're going to be investigating Pascal's Law. First of all, you need this handout. There's not a lot of procedural instructions on this handout, so that's why I'm going to tell you this stuff right now. But it does have some really helpful data tables already for you to collect the data. You should have a bin that's got some stuff in it. It should have a bottle. You're going to need to fill up your bottle. It has some numbers on the side. It goes from 0 to 20 centimeters. And you're going to want to fill up your bottle all the way to the 20. It also has a piece of duct tape covering over two holes. There's one that's kind of towards the bottom. I don't know if you can see it from the back, but it's labeled A. And then there's one about halfway up the bottle that's labeled B. So we're going to be uncovering these holes one at a time and measuring how far the little water spout comes out and how quickly the water level in the bottle drops. You also have a clipboard, and we're gonna use that kind of as a stand or a ledge for our bottle. So we're gonna set it like this, carefully. You also have a ruler, and you're gonna wanna use the centimeter side, and you're gonna wanna place the ruler so the zero is kind of lined up with where the water would be coming out. And then you have a timer that you're gonna be using. So a couple things are gonna be happening all at once. You're gonna need to have one person timing. You're gonna get a reading every 30 seconds, and you can see that on the data table. Okay, so the first data table says hole A, height and distance measurements. So time zero is the horizontal distance is obviously gonna be zero because we haven't started yet. And the water level is already filled out for you. It says it started at 21, and this is just in case you fill it up higher than 21 or 20. So if you have it right on 20, you can change that to be 20. And then the water height above the hole is gonna be the height of the water minus the height of the hole. So we're gonna be doing hole A first, which is this bottom hole. And hole A is at about the 4 centimeter mark on mine. So you might have to adjust your data table. The example is not quite accurate for our bottle. So ours would be 20 centimeters minus the height of hole A, which is 4. So 20 minus 4 would be 16. So that last column, you always wanna do the height of the water minus the same amount every time, which is the height of the hole for your particular bottle, which might not be exactly 4, maybe it's 5. Okay, so when you're ready to get started, you're gonna have one person pull the tape back to just reveal the first hole, and then the timer needs to start. When the timer starts, you're gonna take two readings every 30 seconds. You're gonna read the height of the water level in the bottle, and you're also gonna read how far out the little stream of water is flowing. So that's what the ruler is for, okay? So the horizontal distance is the distance that the water is coming out this way, and then the water level is the water level in the bottle, okay? So every 30 seconds you take that reading. Once it's done, it's not gonna get any farther than the bottom of that hole. You can stop your readings. And hopefully you haven't overflown your bottle or your bin. And then after that, you can cover it back up, fill the water bottle back up, and then you'll do the same thing, but instead of pulling from the bottom for hole A, you'll pull from the top for hole B, okay? So hopefully that gives you an idea of how to get started on the Pascal Law Lab. Okay, so I forgot to tell you one thing, and that is, if you have a black lid on your bottle and it's filled up with water and you try to remove the tape but you leave the top on, there's too much air pressure in the room pushing on the water to let the water back out. So the water won't come out of the hole if you still have this black lid on. So before you start, don't forget to take off this lid, leave it off, and then you can remove the tape and the water will come out of the hole. The magic of air pressure.